Because if you believe in Jesus, the devil is finished underneath your feet. Touching heaven, changing lives. Touching heaven, changing lives. Touching heaven, changing lives. Touching heaven, changing. Expect to touch heaven and receive from God this day. We'll open up our Bibles to 1 Peter chapter 3. Before we go into reading it, we know in Matthew 6, Jesus teaches us on prayer. In Matthew 6 verse 5, Jesus says, and when you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites. For they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners that they may be seen by others. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. You see, in Matthew 6 verse 5, Jesus doesn't say if you pray. But he says when you pray. That means Jesus expects us to be people of prayer. That means Jesus expects us to be people who are connected to him. And not just connected to him. But he speaks in verse 6. He says, but when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your father who is in secret.
That means
Jesus not only expects you to be a person of prayer, but he expects you to be a person of intimate prayer, intimate fellowship, intimate
relationship.
He says, when you pray, go into your room and shut the door. Go into your room and shut the door. That means he's saying, get intimate with your father.
Get intimate
with your father. Get close, get into a deep, deep relationship with your daddy.
So when
you pray,
so
Jesus expects you to be a person of prayer. Secondly, he also expects you to be a person of intimate fellowship, relationship, prayer with your father. Now when we pray, we want to see the fruits of our prayer. We want to see that our God hears us. And we see Jesus says in Matthew 6 verse 6, he says, when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your father who is in secret, and your father who sees in secret will reward you. He says, and your father who sees you in secret will reward you. That means you will receive your reward of prayer. You will receive an answer from God. It may not be pleasing the way you want it. It may not be what you expect it. It will be better than what you expect. But there will be a reply, a reward from God. Many a times we have our own own imaginations, our own desires, that we want God to do it this way. But God knows the beginning from the end, and that's why He will answer it His way.
उफाटी आमची स्वप्न असते, आमची आशा असते की देव त्याच भाषेत जबाब दिलेलो, पण देव आमचं फुडार जाणार, तो आपल्याक जाय त्या भाषेत बरं त्या भाषेत करतलो.
But the assurance Jesus gives,
पण खात्री जी जेजू
दिता, is that when you pray,
की जेव्हा तू मागणी करता,
when you move into that secret place with God,
जेव्हा तू ते गुप्पीत जागेलो ते देव सांगता,
when you begin to seek God face to face,
जेव्हा तू देवाच्या मुखामोर सोडता,
when you are intimate with your God,
जेव्हा तू खासगी संबंध नाही त्या देव
सांगता, Jesus gives you the assurance,
जेजू तुका खात्री देता,
Father who sees you in secret will reward you.
कितु जबाब जो गुप्त के अंदर का पैदा तो तो का बक्शी स्थित हो लास.
But what I want to speak today,
पुंजावाइज उलोंग सत्ता ते,
is from 1 Peter chapter 3.
1 Peter chapter 3 अंसान.
Verse 7.
सातवीं वोइन.
Okay. It seems a long verse. Okay, but I want to focus on the last statement, but we'll read the entire verse. It says, likewise, husbands, live with your wives in an understanding way, showing honor to the woman as the weaker vessel, since they are heirs with you of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered.
की तुझ्या मागण्यांक आडखो येणं जावपाक.
You see, there are principles that God has kept for us.
Their name dorlele asa amcha pasun.
When we follow those principles,
jenami te name patta,
we will begin to experience that abundant life.
Ami te subham jiviton bothoni.
We will begin to see God not only answering the prayers that you have verbally spoken, but even the desires of your heart, He will begin to bless.
Am poito je kite magne tu tonansan kelele sa tezo jawab me ochna punji asha legit asa ti tezo legit jawab me otolo.
When you follow the principle of God,
jena tu deacha ne maza patla kotolo.
Now here we see some of the principles that we will be getting into, is that could, if we don't follow those principles, we would find our prayers hindered.
Ami je ami tore nem poitole ante nem toram padina jam poitole amcha mangnang arkoitol jawab me
par arkoitle. We see we are banging and banging, but there is a cloud, or there is a block, or there is a wall that the prayer is hitting and not getting through.
Am poita matole matole pun kai ek onu dastol na ekar ko astole ki amcha mangne se jawab me ona chaupa.
But those of us who follow, who have that deep intimacy with God and act on what God speaks, they are people that will see the desires, even the desires of their heart, God is blessing.
Am poita je kono to khas ki sambandh se deya sangdan je kon deya jodan se tinchi ek asha lagi deu jawab ditolo tenso.
Today I want to speak on few, there could be many more, but few of the hindrances of to see our prayer answered.
Who bastole punau tode vishulung chote tode tode aike jo amcha magne se jawab me upa kaad kho jata thyo.
The first thing, Isaiah 59 verse 1 and 2.
Pahilan dusri vor.
It says there,
Teshmanta,
behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, or his ear dull that it cannot hear. That means God can hear.
मतलब देखा काय कोयता?
It means God's hand is not short, it's long.
आत मोटवो नाही त्याचं लांब
असतं. It can save.
सालवर करूंग शकता.
But then he says in verse 2.
पण दुसरी वेळ म्हणतो.
But your iniquities have made a separation between you and your God.
पण तुझे पाप कारणे अपराधांग लागून दोषी केलेले असं तुझ्या मध्येगण द्या
मध्ये. Your sins have hidden his face from you.
तुझे पाप कारणे लागून त्याने आपले तोंड लपवलेले असं.
So that he does not hear.
की तो ऐकोना जावपाक.
He does not hear.
तो ऐकोन जावपाक.
You see, many a times we are banging and banging and banging onto the door of God.
Who for them there are mata.
But if your life is not right with God,
पण तुझे जीवित द्याम का सारखे ना.
If that sin that hidden sin that is there is not dealt with,
जे गुप्त पातो का से देजर काम करना चाहिए.
Is not brought at the feet of the cross,
ते तो हमें खुर्सा सोचे आरी ना
चाहिए. Is not brought to Jesus,
जेसु सोचे आरी ना चाहिए.
You will find no matter how much you pray, your prayers are not receiving that reward.
तू पैदो कितले तू मांगने को तू कते मांगने से बक्शिस में आना.
Isaiah 59 he says clearly,
Isaiah 59 and सार की पनी सांगता तो,
so that he does not hear.
की तो ऐकोना जावपाक.
Your sin,
तुझे पातोक,
if it is not dealt with,
ते तुर काढी ना झाल्यार.
If your sin is not dealt with,
तुझे पातकाचे काम करना झाल्यार.
He will not hear.
तो ऐकोची ना.
Your sin is a block.
तुझी पातो काढको जाऊन
असा. Is a hindrance.
ती अडको जाऊन असा.
In Psalms 32.
Psalms 32 अन पैता मी.
He says there.
तो म्हणता तोय.
Psalms 32:1.
पहिले होय.
Till verse 1 and 2. Blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. You know, praise God that today our sin is not only covered, it's washed clean to Jesus.
कि आमचे पाप का फक्त धापकुस ना पण लीप केलेला असे जेचे रोक था.
In the old covenant it was only covered.
बदल्या कारण फक्त धापताले
ते. But today it's washed clean.
पण आज ती धून लीप केलेली
असे. Then he says, blessed is the man against whom the Lord counts no iniquity and in whose spirit there is no deceit. In verse 3 he says, for when I kept silent, that means when I did not confess my sin,
jenai maj patok man gyong na,
when I did not acknowledge my sinful life,
jenai maj pat ke jivit man
gyong na, he says my bones wasted away.
To manta maj hada pdr saling.
When your bones waste away, you will be a jelly.
Jana tu jada pdr te tu jelly bashin jatalo.
My son was asking me a few days back, he was saying, dada, what if we don't have bones?
मज पुत तडे दिसाय ते मगाय सादर दादा आडा ना जा किते जातोले
आम्ही. I said we'll be like jelly.
म्हटलं आम्ही जेली बसून जातोले.
We'll have no firm stature.
आमका स्थिर आकार असची
ना. We'll not carry ourselves with, you know, with proper countenance.
आम्ही आकार घेऊन चोलची ना.
We'll be jelly.
आम्ही जेली बसून
असतो. He says because when you hide your sin,
tumhe jentu aaple patukle
poitha, when sin is unconfessed,
jena patuk tu manun geina,
it's going to destroy your bones.
Te tuje aada nasht kotto ni.
That means
it's what
hidden sin,
gupit
patuk, no matter how much you go to pray,
kitloy magne karun
asa, no matter how much you bang on those God's door,
kitle to deyache derar maru,
if your sin is not brought before Jesus,
tujhe patok to Jesus shaadi
na, if your sin, if you have not forsaken your sinful ways,
tu aaple pat ke vaato sodun deung na sar
yaar, don't expect those bones to be brought back to health,
ti aadang porti bolai ke etle mon chiti na kha,
don't expect God to hear you,
deo tujhe aikotol mon chiti na kha,
we have to deal with sin,
am pat ka chi kaam koru ko sai,
we have to deal with idolatry,
am murti puje chi kaam koru
sai, we cannot come to God with a spirit of idolatry,
amurti pan puja ne cha atme
gyan dyam karim shakna, we cannot come to God with a lying spirit,
I'm floating pan cha atme gyan
dyam, we cannot come to God with jealousy,
I'm kunnat kai gyan
dyam, these are things that we need to bring it before the cross of Jesus,
yo stem jesus che kursa so shadung chai,
he says
to munta,
God's hand is not short.
त्याचा हात मोठा नाही.
His ear is not deaf.
त्याचे कान बहरे नाही.
The reason he is not hearing is because sin is not dealt with.
कारण की तो ऐकोंग शकने की तू पातकाचे काम करणे पातक काढी ना
म्हणा. We have to learn to forsake sin.
आम्ही शिकोंग जे पातक ना करपाक.
If you read in the letters of John.
आम्ही जोयाचे चिठीन पहिल्यार.
In 1 John 3:8, he says, whoever makes a practice of sinning is of the devil.
जो कोण पातकोता तो देवसरस जाऊन असा.
That means if I'm a habituated sinner.
याचा अर्थ की अशीगीत पातक करीत असे झाल्यार.
We may fail sometimes.
जायत गुड केने केने पडो.
But if I'm a habituated person, I practice it daily. He says we are of the devil.
पण दिसपोटी आम्ही पातकोता सोयचेर पडलेले असे ते पातक झाल्यार आम्ही देवसरचे असे
म्हणता. The first reason, as I said.
पहिले कारण जसे सांगलेले असा.
For the hindrance for God to hear me.
आरको की देव ऐकोंग शकना माशे.
Is sin unconfessed.
तेजाने से की पातक मानन गेना सा.
Sin has to be forsaken.
पातक आम सोडकु जाय.
Sin will be a block between God and us.
पातक अडको जातो द्या मध्ये का आणि आमच्या मध्ये
का. But praise be to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ who's bridged that gap.
पण वाखाने आमच्या येशू ख्रिस्ता की त्याने ते गॅप भरून
काढलेला सा. The moment we confess our sin, the gap is filled.
की जेना आम्ही आमच्या पातक मानन गेते ते गॅप भरून काढता.
We are made acceptable before the Father.
आणि आमका मानवलेले को ते बापा मुखार.
Another reason why prayer is hindered.
आणि कारण की मागणे गाळको येता.
If you see in James chapter 4.
James chapter 4 and
verse 3.
तिसरे वचन.
He says, you ask and do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. And then he goes further, you adulterous people, do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Therefore, whoever wishes to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. So what the writer of James is saying,
तो James ऐसा मानता,
many of you are asking and not receiving.
खूब शीघ्र तुम मांगता हैं तुमका मैं होना.
Why?
कितना?
Because you ask the wrong things.
कितना तो false वस्ती मांगता.
You are asking the wrong things.
तो white वस्ती मांगता.
He says, then he goes further to explain it more detail. He says, do you not know that the friendship with the world is enmity with God?
तुम तो नो का इश्ता कुछ सोसर संगत जाओ ना सर दुश्मन का दया संगता.
You see when we know who Jesus is.
जन हमें जाना जीसू क्रिस्ट कौन तो?
When we have an encounter, a deep encounter with God.
जन खोला है तो अनुभव जाता हम से दया संगता.
Our life becomes God-centered.
हम जो जीवित सर के दया चिरा सोंगता.
Our breath, our very being begins to be for God.
हम जो सुस्कल लेके तम जाके जीवित दया का दिला सोंगता.
Our desire becomes God.
हम जो आशित दिव सता.
The world and its ways begin to die down.
सोसर ने जो वाटू मरुंग लगता.
That's why Jesus says, if anyone wishes to follow me, deny himself, carry the cross and
follow me.
Deny yourself, he says. Deny yourself. In simple words, I would put it, die to the world. Die to the things of the world. It's not bad to have the things of the world. But if you're living for the things of the world, that's a problem. Because we are called to live for God. We are called for a purpose. We fulfill that purpose.
That
whatever is needed for your life of the things that are in the world, whatever is needed for you, will God will add it into your life. God wants you to have the best. But we will experience that best when we begin to keep our hearts fixed on God. What James is saying is, you ask but you do not receive. And then he goes on further and he speaks about friendship with the world, his enmity with God. That means what James is saying is, you are asking because your heart is set on the world. And that's why you are not receiving. You see, when our hearts are fixed on the world, when our hearts are fixed to live for the world, when we are set to live for the pleasures of the world, no matter how much you cry out to God, He says you ask but you do not get it, you do not receive. Why? Because you ask for selfish passions that you desire. So if I want God to answer me, I need to realign my life. I need to stop living for the world. I need to stop living for myself. And I need to start living unto the Lord. When I begin to love the Lord and live for the Lord, then He will begin to bless the desires of our heart. If you see in Psalms 37.
Psalms 37 and Pongela.
He says, delight, Psalm 37 verse 4.
So they were in.
He says, delight yourself in the Lord. Okay, Psalm 37 verse 4. Delight yourself in the Lord. And He will give you the desires of your heart. That means live for the Lord. Love the Lord. Hug the Lord. Seek the Lord. And He will give you the desires of your heart. That means He will add everything that is needed for the betterment of your life. So first reason why we have hindrance to prayer is because of sin. Second reason is because there are times that if our hearts are not set on God but in the passions of the world, that's another reason why we will not get our prayers answered. The next reason.
Okay.
In Proverbs 1 verse 24.
Proverbs 1 verse 24.
He says, because I have called and you refused to listen, have stretched out my hand and no one has heeded. Verse 25. Because you have ignored all my counsel, and would have none of my reproof. Then he says in verse 28, then you will call upon me and I will not answer. Basically what God is saying is, when you choose not to listen to me, when you choose to be stubborn in your own ways, when you choose to plan your own plans, come on, there's so many of us who say hallelujah, praise the Lord, but we are scheming our plans inside.
There's
so many of us at times we say, God, I surrender all, but not that one. It's like when it comes to marriage, God, I surrender all, but not that girl, Lord, huh? Please, she's mine. Don't ask
that.
And God is telling you, come on, I have a better plan for you. I want you to forsake that. I want you to forsake that girl, maybe, or that boy. That is, if you're not married. If once you're married, you're in the well, you can't come out of the well. Okay. Then you can't say, God spoke to me to leave you. I did meet one man and said, God told me to leave this woman and catch that woman. I actually met a man and I told him that's wrong. He said, no, but God spoke to me. I said, God spoke to you? Okay, then what can I say? But after 6 months, I met him in the hospital and I said, now what did God tell you? Because he was lying on bed with his leg up and a big hole in his waist. And I said, you have to repent. You have to repent. You have been living in adultery. You have to go back to your first wife. He immediately repented. He cried. He accepted Jesus. And you know, the next thing that happened, the following day, he was healed of every wound. Every doctors had said 5 lakhs would be his expenditure for operation.
The don sanlil ki 5 lakh laktole mana operation a pasot pun jene den boxen mal ta pekoni mel dusre disats.
Sin is a hindrance. When you do your own things, not obeying God, you make your own plans, you walk your own way, and then you say, in your time of crisis, you say, oh God, please help me. God will say, how can I help you? You jumped into the well, now you come out. You have to repent. You have to come in line with God. He says, they have not heard my counsel. They ignored. You ignored my counsel. You refused to listen. That means I'm speaking. I'm directing you. But you chose not to listen because you had made your own desires, your own plans, your own dreams, and now you come to me.
तू ये वेचून काढलेले असं माझ्या ऐकवण्यास बघ, तू आपले ते योजने केलेले, आपले ते आशा दोरलेले, आपले स्वप्न सुपनेलेले, आणि आता तू माझ्या सोशी येलो असा.
Then he says in 28, then they will call upon me and I will also not answer. They will seek me diligently but will not find me. That means you will be desperately searching and you will not be finding God.
मले तू सारखं desperate जाण सोतो पण तू कधी सापडच
नाही. Why?
कित्याक?
Because you are a person who's walking in your own plans, your own dreams, your own counsel. You see, there are some of us who have made our own choices, knowing the choice of God. Knowing what God had for them. And they moved away. Done their own things, and then they have seen what a mess they are in. And no matter how much prayers are made, no matter how much we may be even praying for them, we will find no fruit. Why? Because they are living in disobedience to God. So the first thing, hindrance to prayer, sin. Second, hindrance to prayer is because I'm asking things for my passion, for myself, for my worldly needs. Third thing, my prayers are hindered is because I have chosen not to listen from God, so God has chosen not to listen from us. The fourth point.
So the point.
I like this point because for those of you who are married, this will be really an eye opener.
1 Peter 3.
Let's go now to that scripture. He says, we'll read from verse 1. Okay, if you remember, the seventh verse says, so that your prayers may not be hindered. So that your prayers may not be?
So that your
prayers may not be?
Hindered.
Okay. Now, if you want to understand that portion, you have to start reading from verse
1.
So what should we do so that our prayers not be hindered?
Now,
first he's speaking to the woman.
Okay,
let's read. All you wives, please listen. And all you to-be wives, also listen. Likewise, wives, be subject to your own husbands. Don't be subject to another man. No other person should have authority over your life.
You see,
there is only one authority established over you in your marriage.
Is
wives, submit to your husband.
Thank
God the scripture does not say wives, submit to your mother-in-law.
बरे झाले स्क्रिप्चर असे म्हणू ना की वस्त्र असं ते बायल असं ते आपल्या सासूमायकडे समर्पण
राहा. सबमिट टू युअर हजबंड.
तुझ्या गोवाकडे समर्पण राहा.
ओके, सब्जेक्ट वाईव्स बी सब्जेक्ट टू युअर ओन हजबंड्स सो दॅट इवन इफ सम डू नॉट ओबे द वर्ड दे मे बी वन विदाउट अ वर्ड बाय द कंडक्ट ऑफ देअर वाईव्स. सो ही इज सेइंग
की तो असं म्हणता.
Even if your husband does not believe in Jesus, even if he is a drunkard, an adulterous person, or living a loose life, okay?
He's
saying, subject or submit to your husbands, okay? Then he says, so that even if some do not obey the word, they may be one. How will they be one? Without a word by the conduct of their wives. By the conduct of their wives. Then he says further, when they see your respectful and pure conduct, when they see your respectful and pure
conduct.
In the Amplified Version it says, when they observe the pure and modest way in which you conduct yourself. That means you carry yourself pure, you carry yourself perfect, you conduct your life in a very mannerly way. In fact, in the KJV version, I think in the KJV it says, while they behold your chaste conversation coupled with fear. You know, that means it's not only the way you carry yourself but also how you speak.
तू कशी वागता त्याच भाषेने पण कशी तू उलयता.
Come on, woman. How you speak. You want to win him, right?
तू त्याला जिंकू सोता ना.
By condemning, the reason maybe he's gone into drinking or drugs or whatever bad habit that adulterous woman that he's with is, maybe the reason he's gone there because you've been nagging all your life and now yet you've met Jesus, if you continue nagging, he's going to go more far from you.
कारण की जायत गोरी तो बेबदो झाला असन दुसरे वर्षे सोशे गेला असन जायत गोरी तो त्याका उतरा मारित असलेले आणि आता तो तू तर जेजूक मेहोन करून पासून तसे उतरा मारित असे तो आणि पैसे होतलो.
So your conversation has to be good.
तो तुझे उलो पासा ते बरे असून जाय.
Has to be good. In fact, in one of the places he says, let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt. That means your speech should be gracious, should be good, seasoned, bring healing. You know, salt, it preserves. Salt brings healing.
Pekoni atami.
Salt, when you think of salt, it's used as manure.
Jana meeta vishchita te sare koshe
uzar kota. Your speech should bring about encouragement, should bring about love, should bring about grace towards people that you come in contact with.
Ulo pasate urbadung jay na jal krupadung jay jal lokang sangat tu ulo itha.
So he says, your conversation coupled with fear.
तर तुझ्या उलोपासाते भिरांते सांगता.
What does that word fear mean?
किती काय ते उत्तर भिरांत.
It's not getting scared.
सामके भियो पशे
नाही ते. But it means to coupled with respect.
Respect
your husband. You see, that's the authority God has established. No matter what this present generation may say, maybe the world is saying this is the time of women's liberation. It may be a time for women's liberation, but I want to tell us, according to the Bible, it is time for women submit to your own husbands.
तो दिका देवन स्थापित केलो लासल जाय तो संसार किते म्हणू के उस्तुराची स्वतंत्रता आहे म्हणून पण ओवे लोलस की आम्ही देवन जो स्थापित केलो लास अधिकार तो आम्ही मान पाक
वी हॅव टू फॉलो बिब्लिकल प्रिंसिपल टू सी गॉड हियरिंग आवर प्रेयर
आम्ही त्याचे नेम पाडू को से आमचे मागण्याचे जबाब मे होता तो पाव पाक
मेबी यू द वर्ल्ड विल कम विथ मेनी गुड टिप्स आयडियोलॉजीज फिलॉसफीज साइकोलॉजीज
जाय तो संसार हो विचार घेऊन येत बरे बरे
But there is nothing greater than God's word.
पण त्याच्या उत्तराचे कोण काहीच वाटत
You stand by His word.
And then to take your prayer,
He will answer your prayer.
That you just magnesis jawab di
tolo. He will answer your prayer.
To magnesis jawab di tolo.
You follow His principle.
To take your name part.
His principle.
Take your name.
Not any other principle.
Ani unches name.
No matter how great psychiatrist you will go to.
Kitle orte psychiatrist a gorito.
There is nobody else that can tame your mind the way God's word can.
Dacha utar utrashwa ani kai suje mot sarki korun
shakna. We have to obey His principles.
Ami take your name padukut sai.
So He says.
To tomanta.
So when you look at the word fear means to respect
janam te utar poita biran matlab respect
means, means to appreciate
matlab bahut ulab
admire be devoted to him deeply love him
kolain mok korob te
jan and enjoy your husband
and tuje goa bitor khushi
you follow this principle
tu yane macho patlak ko
you follow this word
tu ya utra cho patlak ko
that whatever you do
ki je kite tu kota
do it to please your husband
tujhe goak dadu shikor pakko
that's the principle of god okay
to dyacho name jano
first you have to love god
pehle matlab tu dyacho mo korunges tujhe goacha kun chor
after your god
tujhe dya pran
the next relationship is your husband
fullo sambandh jano se tujhe go
and you have to respect him love him deeply enjoy be devoted to him appreciate him admire him
and tu teja bidur khush yong jay te kam tejo mo korung jay te kare respect dyung jay
not have arguments
bas bas kor pachhi noi
not pull down
so colored up noi
but submit so one of the principles I believe
to ek ne ma sat manta
is
to jana sa
one of the principles I believe
ek ne
for our prayers to be heard
apne amche magne
for wives I'm talking husbands I'm coming later
baila pasta taun lo eta go
we cannot run away you know for wives
baila pasat
One of the things that you need to understand.
एक पोष्टिते समजून घेऊन जा.
Whatever you do.
जे किते तू करता.
First you do it unto the Lord.
पहिले म्हटलं तू दुनिया द्या पासत कर.
And secondly you do it for the love of your husband.
आणि दुसरे म्हटलं तू गोवाच्या मोगा पासत कर.
Then he goes to verse 7.
मी सातवी ओळ नाही तो.
He says likewise. Husbands live with your wives in an understanding way.
गोवासाठी आपले बायले सांगत राहो समजूनच्या बेश
समजून घ्या. You see God's principle of marriage is nobody is higher than the other.
त्याचो नेम कादरापासत कोण एकम एकाचा उच्च
नाही. The husband is not greater than the wife is not greater than the husband. We are equal.
गोवासाठी बायलेचा गुण उच्च नाही बायलासाठी गोवाचा गुण उच्च नाही
समान असा. He's kept positioning.
Dhyan udhikar dolala asa. Then position dilena asa.
Before the eyes of God.
Dhyachana dhyamakar.
A man and a woman are equal.
Ek ustrane ek dadla sathe samman.
But in a relationship, he's kept positioning.
Pun sambandhan teni position dilena
asa. So as a man,
to ek dadla gojan korun.
He says, live with your wives in an understanding way.
To to manta tuje baile sangat rao somjuni
gyo. That means understand.
Mala somjun gete ka.
Understand. The wavelength how it changes sometimes
samjhan ke kaise the mood badalta
tha understand the mood swings
samjhan ke kaise mood badalta
tha understand the emotional weaknesses that are there
samjhan ke bhavne chije usko kaisa
you see he's encouraging peter is saying understand your wife
peter urpate tha ki samjhan ke aple baile
and then he says showing honor to the woman that is don't treat her like hey, get my socks here
socks
get
are.
My shoes here
shoes are
but honor her
pun maan dite ka
kide honor her
maan dite ka
she's not you know once somebody came to me and said brother I'm looking out for a proposal can you look out for a girl so I asked what do you see what do you want in the girl
tere fate ek chadanun maka osh matlab maka ek choru jay to ten I matlab kite tuka jay choru
abita she just only look after the house
tere matlab ten fakt ghar sa mang jay
So I said, if you want her to look after your house, you look for a servant.
I mean,
why you want a wife?
तेन वक्ती घर सामेलेल तू एक सा करसो बायल कितक जाय तुका
We don't look for marriage for a housekeeper.
I mean, घर पोपक जाय म्हणून घर पोपक जाय म्हणून आम्ही बायल सोदी नाम
We look in marriage for helpmates.
You
see, God, when he saw Adam, he said, it's not good for man to be alone. He needs a helper.
Who needed help?
Adam needed help. And who can help somebody who is able to? Correct. So, a man and a woman, the relationship is not in hierarchy, it's equal.
But
God has established positioning.
Positioning.
And in that position, his wives submit to your husbands. And husbands understand your wives. Honor them. Show honor. And that then, at the end he says, okay, he says, honor the woman as the weaker vessel, since they are heirs with you of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered. That means, if I don't follow this principle of God, my prayers will be hindered. That means, if the wife begins to start putting the pant, that is the authority in the house, that's a problem. That means no matter how much you cry out to God, don't expect God to hear you, because that's a hindrance. If woman, you are dressing up with all the fashionable clothes that you can think of for the world to see you, you are in a problem, because you are only supposed to be pleasing to your husband, not to anybody
else.
And that time you come for a meeting like this and say, hallelujah, God hear my prayer, please change my husband. Come on. The scripture, the principle of God says, you submit to your husband, you begin to conduct yourself in a manner that is worthy, that is perfect, that is your speech should be right, your life should be right.
त्याचं नेम असं म्हणतं की तू आपल्या गोवाकडे समर्पण चल, तुझी रेस्पेदान चल, तुझे जीवित सारखे असू, तुझे उलप सारखे असू जाय.
And when you do that, your prayers will not be hindered. The second principle, men, if you are praying for your family to be blessed, I believe men, you are the head of the family. Husbands, you are the head of the house. You are the priest in the family. You are the representative of the house. You are supposed to carry the family before God.
And
if you do not honor your wife, if you do not know to respect them and understand them, don't expect God to hear you. Don't expect God to come and answer you for your miracle. Husbands, and wives, we have to learn God's principle so that we get God's answer. So we are doing hindrance to prayer. The next reason why we have hindrance to prayer is unforgiveness. In Matthew chapter 6 verse 14 to 15. In verse 14 he says, if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. That means if you forgive others their sin, your Father is going to forgive you. If you don't forgive, your Father is not going to forgive you. We know of the story of the parable of the servant. The unforgiving servant. When he went before his master, he owed his master some crores. But he begged before the master and said, "Forgive me."
पण त्याने भीक मागली आपल्या मास्टरशी आणि म्हटले आपल्या माका बक्षी.
And the master felt pity on him and forgave him.
आणि मास्टर चुचुरे दिसले आणि त्याने बक्षीले त्याला.
But when the same servant went out, he caught his fellow servant who owed him maybe 1,000 rupees.
पण जेने तो चाकर असेल तर बाहेर गेला आणि त्याने दुसऱ्या चाकराक दोरले जो त्याला 1,000 रुपये देऊपायचा असेल जायत कोणी.
He caught his servant, fellow servant, and said, "You have to owe me every rupee."
त्याने चाकराक दोन म्हटले तू सगळे पैसे देऊन जाय माका.
Then the master heard this.
आणि जेने मास्टर
angry about it.
तो रागर झालो ते छेद.
Just before
ते जादी
when he pleaded to the master heard.
जेने ते बिग मागले ते सकरन देने देने मास्टर ऐकले.
Now this servant is not willing to forgive his fellow servant.
आता ओचा कोणास आता आपले दुसरे चाकरा बुक्स सोडिना.
Master calls him.
मास्टर आपयता तेका.
And judges him.
आणि चोटियाटा ते छेद.
And no matter how much he cried for pity.
आणि कितलोय तो रडो चुचरे पास.
He was not heard.
तेजे ऐकोंग ना कित्याक.
Because of an unforgiving spirit.
कित्याक बक्षी नसताना
he was not willing to forgive.
तो तोय नसलो बक्षीपा.
You see, when we are living in unforgiveness, we cannot expect God to hear our prayer.
जेने बक्षी नसताना राहजल देव आमच्या मागणे जबाब मे दितोल म्हणजे
चित पाच नाही. If you are living in unforgiveness towards your brothers, your sisters, your husband, your wife, your whoever it may be, if there is unforgiveness inside of you, God will not hear you.
तुझे भावक ना बोइनिंग ना जगवाक ना बायले बक्षीण असताना आसान बक्षीण असताना बक्षीण दिन असताना रावलेलं असं जर देव जवळ दिलं म्हणून चिती नका.
Unforgiveness is an hindrance before God.
बक्षीण असताना राव ती अडखळ जाणं असं द्या मुखा.
Maybe some of you are waiting for God for your miracle.
जर तुझे जण रावलं असं ध्यान मिलाग्र कर.
Maybe you are waiting for God to bring healing.
जर तुझे जण रावलं असं देव पिकोणी आठ.
Maybe you are waiting for God to bring change to your husband.
जर तू रावलं असं तुझे गोक पे बदल पाडता.
Maybe you are waiting for God for your miracle, for your job.
जायत कोई तुझे कामाच्या बाबतीत मिलाग्र करावलेलं
असतं. Let us ask ourselves this question today.
पण आम्ही आमकाच जो प्रश्न विचारूया.
Are we living in unforgiveness?
आम बक्षीण असताना असं का?
Are we people that have held on to hatred towards somebody else?
आम्ही द्वेष घेऊन असं का दुसऱ्याविषयी?
Are there people that have hurt us that we have kept it into our hearts?
लोकांनी आमका दुखवलं असं ते आम्ही आमची काळजण घेऊन असं का?
You see, it is easy for us to come here and praise God.
सोपे जात आम्ही हंगासून येऊन देवाक वाखाणता.
But God knows us for who we are on the inside.
देव जाणे आम्ही भीतरसान कोणती.
God knows us how much hate, pain, hurt feelings we have on the inside.
देव जाणे कसे दुखाची भावना कसे द्वेष आम्ही घेऊन बसलेले असते
भीतर. We cannot come before God with makeup.
आम्ही मेकअप लावून कोण द्या मुखाने.
He knows you for who you are.
तो जाणे तू कोण तो.
He knows you for who you are.
तो जाणे तू कोण तो.
And if there is pain inside of you,
दुख असे तो तुझे भीतर.
Let us open up our hearts to him and confess it.
आम्ही आमचे काय चुकते कोणी त्याच्या मुखाने मानून घेऊया.
Let's forgive those who have hurt us.
बक्षीया जे कोणी आमका दुखवलेले
असते. Let's forgive those who say they are enemies.
आम बक्षीया जे कोण म्हणता किती आमचे दुश्मन.
Let's forgive them.
आम बक्षीस थैंक
यू. God would find our prayer pleasing before him.
की देव आमचे मागणे सर दादोशी म्हणून जाऊ पाकते.
If you're having an issue with your husband or with your wife,
जे गोसंग ने बायले सांगते की ते विषय असं झालं यार.
I believe today is a day maybe you could make your decision that says, no, I'm going to walk by God's principles.
आज जाऊन सर वीज जे तू म्हणू शकता की आओ देवाच्या नियमाप्रमाणे चालतो.
I'm going to honor my wife.
आम माझे बायलेक मान देतो.
I'm going to submit to my husband.
आम माझे गोवाकडे समर्पण
करतो. No matter what they are.
की ते असो ते.
I believe God has power. He is almighty and he is able to bring change in my household.
असो मन ते देव पोपोद्वीच जाऊन सांग ते गडी गोट की बदल पाडबक माझे घरा बिया.
For my husband to change.
माझे गोक बदलपा.
For my wife to change.
माझे बायलेक बदलपा.
If I only follow his principle.
आपो तेचे नेम पाडी चालले.
God's principle.
देवाचे नेम पाडी
चालले. God will begin to work.
देव काम करतोलच.
God will begin to act.
देव काम करतोलच.
If you are blessed by this message, stand with us in spreading the gospel of Christ. If you wish to partner with us, send your tithes and offerings in favor of Awake Ministries at Awake Ministries, care of Abel Vaz, B304, Brindavan Apartment, VS Dimpo Marg, Tonka, Karanzalam, Goa. Our PIN code is 403002. And our bank details are Oriental Bank of Commerce, Miramar Branch, account number 10722191002621, IFSC code, ORBC 01010072.